More than 50 Adelaide lawyers have joined a program to mentor Indigenous law students, giving them valuable real-world experience as they prepare to enter the legal profession. It comes as a new report reveals that Aboriginal youth are 20 times more likely than others to be in detention, at a cost of $1,000 a day per person. Karen Ashford reports.
It's a social event with a serious purpose, connecting students with practising lawyers to give them an inside running in this competitive profession.
It's unheard of that law students have a mentor in the law field that's succeeding and is willing to give you their time outside from their cases. So we're really lucky that we get to come to gatherings like this tonight and meet on a, you know, on a social platform, but also, you know, be able to contact them when time gets tough.
For one, it's a jump from the wrong side of the law.
You know, I've had personal experiences with, you know, being in the, you know, criminal world, unfortunately, so, yeah.
An experience that's now shaping her career path.
Juvenile justice, because, you know, I've had a lot of, you know, family members that, you know, were young offenders, and I think that, you know, early intervention is really important and to support our younger generation.
A South Australian Council of Social Service report has revealed Aboriginal 10 to 17-year-olds make up 46% of young people in detention and 34% in community-based supervision.
We have an average of 56 or so kids in detention at any one time, but in fact the great, almost half of those are kids who are Aboriginal, where in fact they represent only 4% of our population.
An Indigenous justice agreement is suggested as one possible solution. Boosting Indigenous legal professionals is another.
I think too often in the past, Aboriginal peoples have been disconnected from the legal system. So this is, I think, about changing that.
They get a growth in confidence. They also have a connection to the legal fraternity, so they get exposure across all different mediums of the law, not just criminal, so there's corporate law, civil law, family law.
The program has seen 11 students graduate since 2005 and has 17 participants today, with a founding member predicting it will continue to grow.
The students are making great connections and it's been going for 10 years, and so we've got some impetus behind us, and people think that we'll keep going, so I think it's been fabulous.
Students agree.
And that's what it's all about, providing Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander law students with the opportunity to be familiar with the legal profession and to really make a difference and to be comfortable. I think that's the key here, is to be comfortable in your cultural identity but also your place in the legal profession.
Karen Ashford, NITV News.